Welcome back to the Cape for the Cast, the podcast that's not really a podcast. Today we're talking about fan casting. And next week, and probably the week after.
Oh shit, we're rolling?
We are rolling. We're going to do me today. Yay!
I mean, I do you all the time, so it's all good.
I am casting Zelda.
And Link.
And Link, and a lot of others. So, I'm doing Ocarina of Time, right? Yeah.
That movie.
Yeah, Ocarina of Time movie casting. Although I didn't cast a director. Can you cast a director? Is that casting? That's not casting. That's
I mean, just you can come up That's with who hiring. You want to.
That's just hire.
Like, you've got the cast, and then you can come up with who you'd want to tackle it.
I'm going to have to think about director. Oh, I got it.
You thought real hard about that one.
Don't need to think hard about it. Later, that's going to confuse me if I don't do that.
So, but at least you didn't say you want to get, like, lynched to direct it or something.
That was in my head. I'm not casting kids. I find kids are always best when they're unknowns. And, yeah, so not casting the kids, casting the adults. And I'll start with my most proud cast, Idris Elba as Ganondorf.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah. I don't know anyone else who could do that better, except for maybe, like, Morgan Freeman 40 years ago. But Idris Elba works right now. Yeah. So, Zelda is someone I actually don't remember who that is. I know I went on a search to find the perfect person for Zelda, and I never really found it, but I settled on this person.
I think she was, like, in one horror movie or something.
Her name is Abby Lee. Oh, that's right. In Mad Max Fury Road, she was one of the girls in the truck with, like, the white robe stuff.
Still never saw it.
You need to see that.
I know, I do.
There were some pictures that made her look like the right person to play it. I don't know if she's any good at acting. I don't know if she'll fit the rest of the cast, but she kind of looks the part, and
that's what really matters.
I find, especially with this kind of fan casting, that's what matters. Because playing Zelda, I don't think you could do it as someone who's already well known enough to be sort of like... This turned. Sorry.
You don't want someone that's going to feel too important to have such a small role because Zelda's never really around.
Yeah, also, like, Zelda is kind of... Even though small role, but it very important, and having someone who's maybe known as someone else from a different franchise, it would take that away from Zelda. It'd be like Harry Potter playing Link, right?
Yeah. You wouldn't be able to think of it as anything other than Harry Potter.
Yeah. You check that out.
Sorry, Daniel Radcliffe, you're never escaping that one. I say like he's watching.
I hope so.
That'd be great.
That would actually be pretty cool. If you are watching, hi.
Hey,
what's up?
I like your other work.
Yeah, me too.
Mulan, because she's a redhead. Karen Gillan, and she's adorable too.
It's weird that you say it like that, because I always say Malin.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I think everybody does.
Because Lon Ranch, Mulan.
Yeah, I've always said Malin and Talon.
You say Lon Ranch?
No, I don't.
So I think that's a perfectly good casting.
Yeah.
What say you? Because I'm just saying things and no discussion.
That's fine.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean.
Now, this Sam helped me with because I had no idea. Princess Rudo, adult, Rosario Dawson. Why?
I remember why.
Reasons.
Okay.
Couple of reasons.
Yeah.
Oh, two reasons in specific. okay. Actually, I said Idris Elba was my favorite and best casting for me here, but that's not true. It's the guard that's the same everywhere.
Yes.
Fucking Paul Rudd has to be that guy. Just Paul Rudd all over Hyrule. Oh, man, we got some good ones here, actually.
Yeah.
Happy Mask Salesman. Has to be a cameo from Shigeru Miyamoto.
Has to be. Yeah, you can't not have Shigeru Miyamoto, especially considering the fact he's going to be packing a Mario mask in the shop somewhere, too.
Yeah.
Like the one he's got on his pack in Majora's Mask. Mm-hmm. He'll have that sitting somewhere in the shop.
Yeah.
Maybe he'll even put it on and just be like...
Okay, I'm just gonna bounce around here.
Yeah, because I mean, you haven't even gone for Link yet.
Yeah, I was gonna do Link last.
Yeah.
So Dompei? How do you pronounce it? Dompei.
I was calling him Dumpy.
Dumpy.
Yeah. Dumpy the Gravekeeper. And Dumpy the Gravekeeper. Keep them graves.
I think this was another good one you suggested. Jean Reno.
Yes.
It'd be fucking great. Just like a hunched over Jean Reno, like sort of all in white face.
But the one change you'd have to make to the character is that he'd have to have Jean Reno's beard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which, I mean, I think he didn't have stubble because of just limitations. Of
the Probably, yeah.
Maybe.
So I feel like he would have, like, just because he's old and just like... Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
This one almost seemed pretty obvious to me as Impa Tilda Swinton, simply because of her role in... Doctor Strange.
Yeah.
It's very similar.
That is a very obvious casting choice.
Yeah, and she looks really good one. Like Impa as well, except maybe the lips. Mm-hmm. I know Impa had pretty big lips, I think.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's
probably, again, just limitations of the N64.
Yeah.
I'm limited to only making huge lips.
Only huge lips or no lips, just a line.
Yeah.
Yeah. You either get a line or giant lips.
Okay.
You're just duck facing all over Hyrule.
I was happy to do this one. I think Darunia would be really great. Having Dave Bautista playing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just picture him doing the dance.
Yeah, totally.
As Sarah's song starts playing. He's fucking like bouncing back and forth and fucking going. Gotta bust out that Darunia dance.
Just looking at Ingo, this one seems pretty obvious. And it's probably because Ingo's very based off of Luigi. So John Leguizamo is perfect for it. Because... Say what you will about that movie, John Leguizamo was perfect.
It's Mario, Mario, and it's Luigi Mario.
Yeah. I guess that's pretty much everything except for Link. Now, Link was really, really, really hard, and we went on a long search for Link. Link and Zelda were both really hard. Mm-hmm. We
those
settled...
All the polygons, you know?
Yeah.
Hard edges, just anyway.
This guy is from S.H.I.E.L.D., right?
He was in Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., yeah. He's in a few other things, too.
Yeah. Yeah. Luke Mitchell. There was one picture in specific that made me go, like, that could really be Link.
Mm-hmm.
He had the persona there going on.
Yeah.
So just look around at him. Maybe I'll...
Just look at pictures of him without a beard, and you'll be able to find it a little easier.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because when he's beardy, it's like, nah, you're not Link. But as soon as he's, like, clean-shaven and whatnot, I'm like... I could slap a green fucking pointy, saggy hat on your head and
pointy,
like...
Pointy, saggy
hat. Well, it comes to a point and it sags on the back of his head. It's a pointy, saggy hat. Or it's a saggy pointy
hat. Oh, I missed one. Oh, well.
Who did you miss?
Raru.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Fucking Ben Kingsley.
Yep. Sir Ben Kingsley as Raru.
Yeah. I don't think it
and,
could
and,
get much better
and,
than that.
And CG'd to also play Kapora Gabora.
Totally.
Yeah.
Actually, I missed a bunch of stuff, actually. The three great fairies. Felicia Day, Ivana Lynch, which is, I lost her name.
The whimsical one from Harry Potter.
Yeah, the silly blonde girl with the glasses.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And, Zoe Saldana.
Yeah.
All very extravagant, awesome women. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. And at the beginning of the video, I was like, I know the director, fucking David Fincher. Dude can do a mystery. And, like, what's going on with this time travel shit? What's going on with this Ganondorf bastard? He could pull that.
Yeah.
He could pull it. Imagine 7, but Zelda.
The Legend of Zelda 7.
If only we did that many movies. So 7 in. That's exactly what it is.
That's all I've ever called it.
I have no idea how long this video was. Any other thoughts?
Yeah, man. Nibiru.
Oh.
Put you on the spot there.
I have to take a look at her. Is that your spot?
Yeah, I think so.
K can't reach that site because it's not a site. Okay. Yeah.
She's a babe.
She is a babe.
Mm-hmm. I always wanted to do a cosplay of her. But I did, what's her face? Twin Rova, which has got kind of a similar style.
Mm-hmm. Need someone who would look good in that, like, in that Gerudo nose. Mm-hmm. You'd have to have some prosthetics going to get that, like...
Which is interesting, actually. Yeah, they do definitely have the big noses. This picture does not.
No. Well, yeah, that's like anime fatter. Version.
Yeah. That's and this like. Is more... Actually, that's a realistic look.
Let's see. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. What are... I mean, there's not enough, like, medium dark-skinned actresses, like Indian or Middle Eastern actresses in Hollywood. Mm-hmm. There's a fair amount of black actresses and a bajillion white actresses, mm-hmm. and not a lot of the in-between.
You know what? How about we do another video called Casting Nibiru? It's just our search for the perfect Nibiru for a movie that's, you know, fictional anyways.
That's interesting. I wonder where they got the clothing design for that. Okay, well, maybe if I find someone, I'll just, like, put it right here.
That's a great choice.
Yeah, I know. Thanks.
She's perfect.
So perfect, yeah.
Amazing.
Okay, next week, what are we doing?
Professor Layton, the movie. A production by me.
Yes.
Look forward to it. Bye. Do what it says on this piece of paper here.
Figure it out.